गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो हाउ आर यू ऑल?
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
सो लेट अस कंटिन्यू। वी वर डूइंग काउंटिंग प्रॉपर कलरिंग। So in the last class, we have seen this. So mainly, we were discussing chromatic polynomial. Chromatic polynomial. Okay. So we derived four formulas: chromatic number of kn using k colors. So it is k into k minus 1, k minus 2, and up to k minus n plus 1. Okay, and then we derived chromatic polynomial for kn bar using k colors, and this is k raised to power n. And third chromatic polynomial of tree with n vertices and having using 10 colors, so or in terms of k, so it was k into k minus 1 raised to power n minus 1, and last we discussed this one, chromatic polynomial for C4, okay, in terms of k. So it was, yeah, so what was this? K into k minus 1 k square minus 3k plus 3. Okay, so anyone has doubt in this? So we can simply, you know, we proved in fact all, like give you justification how we get this. Just you have to count the number of total proper coloring, you know, of that graph using k different colors. Okay, so let's continue with this.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next thing is, today I would like to discuss about, so we discussed actually in the last class, we discussed the counting of number of proper coloring and the chromatic polynomial of a graph, and today we'll discuss chromatic recurrence, and second point, we'll solve some problems if time permits. Okay, so in the last class we have seen a proposition. So I would like to repeat that from here. So we have seen that the notation, like, you know, NPR, so that has the some different notation I used, like in book they use N suffix R, okay, they are same thing. So if I use this, so you know that the meaning of this X suffix R is X into X minus 1, x minus 2 till r terms, okay, the meaning actually permutation of x objects are taken r at a time. So first object has x twice, x minus 1, x minus 2, you have to write the r terms. So rth term will be x minus r plus 1, okay. And we have also seen, so if prg, okay, denote the number of partitions, so number of partitions of vertex set of the graph into R non-empty independent set. Okay, means vertex set, you have to partition the vertex set into R independent sets. And then we have seen the expression for the chromatic polynomial. Chi gk, and this is summation PR of g times kr, r varies from 1 to number of vertices. Okay, and you have seen this is actually a polynomial in k, okay, of degree ng. So I think I have not proved this result, so we can give the argument or justification to prove this. Okay, one, let us prove this. Okay, this result you have to remember, this is present for the chromatic polynomial. So proof goes this way. When R colors are used, when R colors are used in a proper coloring, so the color classes, so the color classes partition vertex set, this VG, into exactly R independent sets. Okay, okay, we have total k available colors, but R of them we have to use. Okay, so if R colors are used in a proper coloring, then the color class partitions vertex set into R independent sets. Okay, so one set will consist of, like, one independent will consist of vertices of same color, then second independent set will consist of independent set of second color. Okay, and so on. So Rth independent set will be the set of vertices of Rth color. And which can happen in PRG ways. So PRG was actually number of partitions. Okay, so how many different way we can partition a vertex set into R independent set. Okay, and we have k colors available. So right, when k colors are available, when k colors are available, there are exactly k r number of ways to choose r colors. Okay, from na that k colors. So you can see this kr is actually kpr. So we have total available k colors, and we want to use r of them. Okay, so permutation of k objects taken r at a time, so this is kpr, or we need k suffix r. So this many way we can arrange k colors into r different independent sets. Okay, so one independent set will be given one color, so we can permute in kr ways. Okay, so when k colors are available, there are exactly kr number of ways to choose r color from k colors and assign them to the classes. Okay, so color class, you can see, assign them to the classes. So all the proper coloring, all the proper coloring arise in this way. So in this way we count all the proper coloring. Okay, and so the formula, you know, this formula chi of gk holds like p r g into, then you do r partitions of a vertex set of a graph, and you have kr number of way to assign r colors to them, and r has different possibilities, so r can be 1, 2 vertex set. And then this formula holds. Okay, furthermore we can write, so furthermore, as kr is a polynomial in k. Okay, so you know the kr. Kr is k into k minus 1 into k minus 2 and so on up to k minus r plus 1. Okay, so kr you already know. K minus 1, k minus 2, okay, and k minus r plus 1. npk, okay. Also kpr actually, sorry. So actually k suffix r is a polynomial in k, okay. And PRG is a number, is a constant. Every time it is a constant, because you PRG is a number of partition of the vertex set into R independent set. So you have to, this is a number, constant. And how many partition you can do, that will give, this is a number. So actually this expression we hold, now I want to prove that this is a polynomial of degree NG. That's why we are giving next arguments. So kr is a polynomial in k, and actually kr will have degree k, actually k terms will be there, first term, second term, third term, sorry, not k term, r terms. So k suffix r, so we are taking r terms, so degree will be r actually, okay, for in kr. So a polynomial k of degree r, and prg is constant. So constant for each r. Okay, so from here you decide, okay, so like r varies from 1 to ng, so r can have maximum value ng, okay. So since kr for the fixed value of r, it is a polynomial of degree r, and r can vary till ng, okay. Ng is a number of vertices in graphs, that's why in all you see this expression is going to be polynomial of degree ng, or order of the graph. So PRG is a constant for each R, and therefore you see that chi G comma K is a polynomial, okay, in K. And like when G has n vertices, okay, or you can say G has n vertices. So when G has n vertices, there are there is exactly one partition of vertex set, okay, into n independent set. Can you tell me that partition? So since a graph has n vertices, okay, and you want to partition into the n independent set, so that partition will be what? All will be singletons, right? So one color class will have single element, you know? So all n color class will have n, each will have single element. Are you getting? So there are n vertices, and you can partition that into at max you can partition that into n independent sets. So what will happen? And since it has n vertices, so can you partition it into n plus 1 independent set? Is it possible? क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर. वी हैव एन वर्टिसेस इन अ ग्राफ एंड वी वॉन्ट टू पार्टीशन द वर्टेक्स सेट इन टू एन प्लस वन इंडिपेंडेंट सेट. इज इट पॉसिबल और नॉट? नॉन एम्प्टी इंडिपेंडेंट सेट. Are you getting my question? So I said G has n vertices, so there is only one, exactly one partition of vertex set into n independent set, and that will be singleton set. And if I want to ask you whether can we partition the vertex set into n plus one classes or n plus one independent sets, so it is not possible actually, because you have only n vertices.
No, sir.
If you take singletons, then you will have only n partitions. So if you want to partition into n plus 1 classes, you don't have n plus 1 vertices actually, you have n only. So that will not be possible. Okay. So that's why you can write. So you can write and no partition using more than n sets. Okay. So if you take more than n sets, there will not be such partition of n plus 1, n plus 2 sets. In fact, independent set I'm talking, you know. More than n non-empty independent set. So you cannot partition. So the maximum you can do, you can partition the vertex set into n independent sets. And that is going to be the maximum number of partitions, you know. So what we are trying actually, so R can take maximum value ng, number of vertices. Okay, so that's why, so the leading term actually, the leading term in chi gk is k raised to power n also. N, I'm taking number of vertices. If number of vertices ng, so you can write k power ng. This is going to be leading term, and that's why we get, so therefore we get this has a degree n. Okay, n means number of vertices. I have started with, I assume number of vertexes, okay, n, that's why I said n, otherwise you can write ng. So hence this proves that chi gk is a polynomial in k with degree ng, with degree ng. Okay, number of vertices. Okay, so this result proved, and you know four results already, so let me go to the other way. Okay, so can we find the expression using some other way? So I would like to, okay, so again I'm repeating, this is a polynomial of degree k. Okay, this is chromatic polynomial of graph g using k colors. Okay, in k, so again kn, chromatic polynomial for kn is what? So I would like to ask you, so do you remember I have written today also and last class also, so what was the answer for this? Because this is going to be used later on, so you have to remember this formula. What is the expression for this chromatic polynomial of kn? Yes, I'm asking you, what is the chromatic polynomial for kn? Means you have k colors and you want to find the number of proper coloring of the graph kn using k colors.
Sir, k into k minus 1, k minus 2 up to k minus 1, n plus 1.
Yes, k, k minus 1, k minus 2, k minus n plus 1. Correct, good. सो सेकेंड इज क्रोमैटिक पॉलीनोमियल फॉर के एन बार कॉमा के, है ना, के एन कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो वी हैव टू काउंट द नंबर ऑफ पार्टीशंस ऑफ के एन कॉम्प्लीमेंट यूजिंग के कलर्स. सो दिस वॉज वॉट दिस वॉज के रेस टू पावर एन. ओके, थर्ड वी डिराइव्ड क्रोमैटिक पॉलीमर फॉर टी एन थ्री विथ एन वर्टिसेस यूजिंग के कलर्स. सो वॉट वॉज दिस
k into k minus 1 to the power m minus 1.
Yes, so this was this, and the last result I used chromatic polymer of C4 using k colors using this formula. So what was this?
K into k minus 1 into k to the power k square minus 3k
k plus 3. Okay. So this you have to remember. Okay, now actually for every graph, if you have some complicated graph, so it is not possible always to use this formula, and this will take too much time. You can do, but we want to have some easier way to find this chromatic polynomial. So actually in remark, I would like to tell you that okay. So actually what, like computing chromatic polynomial, okay, of graph G using above formula. So what formula we proved? Using above formula is not generally feasible. Okay, is not generally feasible. Is not generally feasible because it will take too much time or it may be too much complicated. As there are too many partitions to consider. Okay, so if you use ever formula, so you have too many partitions to consider. Like partition into one set, into two set, into three set, into four sets, okay? So as many vertices it has, then you have to again count how many partition you can do, okay? So like since C4 we did last one, so since C4 was relatively easy, so C4 was relatively, you can say simple graph, so relatively it was easy graph, okay, to partition. But for graph of higher order, okay, but for the graph of higher order and higher size, so for graph of higher order or higher size, it becomes complicated. Okay, it becomes complicated. So what we want actually, so we go for a recursive computation. Okay, so we go for a recursive computation. Which is very much similar, which is very much similar to that and actually what we do in recursive computation. So actually we want to go for recursive computation, and which is very much similar to that used to count, so that used to count number of spanning trees actually, so number of spanning trees by contraction, so by contraction of an edge, So actually in the recursive computation, we want to count the number of spanning trees, okay, by contraction of an edge. So I will explain what is the contraction of an edge. So let me call this edge E. So by contraction of an edge E in a graph G. In a graph G. So question is, what is this contraction of an edge? So actually, we first have to define the word contraction of an edge, okay? So let's first explain this word, then we'll go ahead. So things we have to explain, contraction of an edge in graph G, okay? So if you define this, so contraction of an edge means, so let me first write the definition that you will understand. So in a graph G, contraction of an edge or contraction of edge E with endpoints U and V. Okay, so U and V are the endpoints of edge E. With a single vertex. Okay, so what we do in a graph G, contraction of edge E with endpoints U and V with a single vertex. So what we do actually, we do, there are two endpoints, okay, of edge E, you know, and what you do actually, you just do the contraction of edge with just one vertex, okay. So in place of U and V, you just take one vertex. So actually you shrink, so I will write. So U and V with a single vertex whose incident edge is are the edges other than E. And that were incident to U or V. Okay. So, like the resulting graph, so we denoted by G dot E. Means we are doing a contraction of edge E in graph G, has one less edge than G. Actually, what we do actually, we do contraction of an edge, so we actually remove the edge between U, V, and you just U and V, you consider just one vertex. So let me explain with an example so it will be easier. So for example, look at this graph. Okay, and let's say E is this one. So yeah, this is U and this is V. So in this graph G, you have an edge E and we have endpoints of E as U, V. So we want to do contraction of this graph. So we want to find actually G dot E. Means we want to do contraction of edge E. So what you do actually? So you have to replace actually U and V with a single vertex. You have to replace U and V with a single vertex. Rest all thing will be similar. See this U and V, You just consider this UV as one vertex. Okay, this is. And now you see, okay, let me name other also. A, B, C. So look carefully. Like, let me write A here, B here, and C here. Okay, this is UV. So what you will do, actually, this U and B, both the vertex, you will replace by just one vertex. So this will be a one vertex. You can name it new something W like. So U and V both, and you remove that A is between UV. So you remove the A is between UV and take UV as the single vertex, U and V both. And join all other edges like earlier. So like A to U, there was one, so you can draw A to W. B to V, you can draw B to W. Because U and V, you have taken only single vertex. You remove that edge. And C to U, so you might see, okay, there was one edge between C to U, one edge was C to B. Okay, you can make like this. But actually, so any problem in this? What we did? We did contraction of this edge. So we removed that edge and the endpoints we took together. Just consider one endpoint in place of both and remove the edge between them, that two vertex actually. So this is called the contraction of the edge in a graph. So if I explain more, like this will be actually equivalent to, so since the number of proper k coloring is unaffected by multiple edges, okay. So if you do proper coloring, so you don't have to keep it multiple edges. So you just have to replace this multiple edges with single edge. Okay. So actually this will be equivalent to this G dot E is equivalent to the graph for the proper coloring. You can write it like this. So A to W, B to W, and this C. A, B, I named it W, and this C. So this is both are equivalent for the proper K coloring. So let me write the remark. So like since the number of proper K coloring, okay. So the number of proper K coloring is unaffected by multiple edges. Okay. So why so? So actually we just count in the number of proper coloring, you just count how many way you can color the vertices. Okay. So multiple edge will not play the role, okay? So edge will not play the role in the counting the number of proper coloring. Right? We just see, okay, so at the every endpoints of the edge should have different color, okay, in proper coloring. So it doesn't matter, it has one edge or two edge or three edge. Now, so in proper coloring, they will not matter. So since the number of proper K coloring is unaffected by multiple edges, so we discard, okay, so what we do, we discard multiple copies of edges, okay. So we'll discard multiple copies of edges that arise from the contraction. That arise from contracts. Okay. So keeping one copy of each, right? So like keeping just one copy, okay, of each to form single graph. Form simple graph. So we are interested in just simple graph, okay. So we'll make it simple graph and we'll ignore multiple edges. We just take one edge, you know, in place of multiple edges, because in we are interested in proper counting, you know. So number of proper counting will not be affected by multiple edges or single edges. So in contraction, we'll just consider simple graphs. Na? We'll ignore multiple edges. So any doubt till now? So we just discussed chromatic polynomial. Okay, then we started with this contraction because we want to have some other way of chromatic polynomial, to find chromatic polynomial or to count the number of proper coloring. So we want to go with the recursive method. So for recursive computation, we have to do contraction of edges. So in that, we were interested in just counting the number of spanning trees actually. So first I define what is the contraction of edge in the graph, okay? Now, let me write. So you understood, okay? You can do contraction in any graph. Just you replace both the vertex of that edge as single vertex and remove that edge. So next result I have, or proposition you can say, theorem of proposition. So this is chromatic recurrence. So this is the result. So this result is, if G is a simple graph, okay, and the notation was G dot E, okay, G dot E is the notation for contraction of edge E in graph G. So if G is a simple graph and E is one edge in graph G, okay, then we are interested in chromatic polynomial of graph G, na, or number of proper coloring of the graph G using K colors. And that result says this is chromatic polynomial for graph G minus E minus chromatic polynomial of graph G dot E. So G dot E is a contraction, okay? G minus E is removing the edge. Comma K. So this is the formula. Okay, this is the chromatic recurrence formula. So this formula may help us to save from complicated calculations. So I think we have to prove that. So before proving, we can try few examples based on this, and we'll check whether it works or not. Okay. So first, let us verify for C4 only, because for the C4 we already have the expression for chromatic polynomial. So first, let me verify. So graph G I would like to consider as C4 only, okay, and then I would like to verify using this formula whether it gives the correct answer, okay, just verification. So I am interested in chromatic polynomial of C4. So first C4, okay, 1 minute. So let me draw a graph. So this is C4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you can name it A, B, C, D. Okay, now this is graph G. So G I have taken as C4. And now you can consider one edge. So any one edge you can consider. Okay, you can take any one edge as E. So which one should I consider as E? Tell me. Which one you want? There are four edges. So any one you can consider. Yes, which one is your favorite? Tell anyone. Yes, which one you want to consider as G? A, B, B, C, C, D, 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 A, which edge?
Any of them, sir. C, let's take C, sir.
C to what? Edge.
The B, C.
Okay, let's take B, C. Okay, this is edge E. So now, what we need two thing in the recursive formula. Okay, so in this chromatic recurrence identity, we need G minus E and we need G dot E. So you know two both the things. G minus E is just removing that edge. So just removing that edge will produce this graph. Okay, we are just removing that edge. So it's a A B C D. Okay, and G dot E means you will shrink this edge, you will remove this edge and join. I mean, take one vertex in place of BC. So BC will consider one vertex, and you have D here, you have A here, A D. In place of BC, you will take just one vertex. You can join it. This, this, this. Fine. So in place of B and C, you will take one vertex and remove that edge, and now join like earlier. So CD and BA was there. Yes, you can name it new, some new vertex. Okay, so like I may name W or something. Okay, now using above formula, so let's put that formula. So formula, I have chromatic polynomial of graph G comma K is chromatic polynomial of G minus E comma K minus chromatic polynomial G dot E minus K. Okay, so let me start with G. I have taken C4 comma K. And now tell me, G minus E, what is the name of G minus E? This graph is what?
Sir, a tree, sir.
No, it is, tree, you can say it is P4. Yes, it is tree, correct. Is it P4, you can say?
Yes, sir.
Yes, and this is what? This is K3? G dot E?
K3.
Yes, so G minus E is a tree, which is P4, and G dot E is K3. So G minus E I can replace by P4 comma K minus G dot E is K3 comma K. Now P4 is a tree with four vertices. Okay, so this is a tree with four vertices. So you can say this is a tree with four vertices, and we have the result actually. Okay. So we already derived the result for the tree with four vertices, with n vertices. Tell me, what is the answer for this? What's right here? It has four vertices. In place of n, you write four. So you have the result for the tree of n vertices. So P4 is the T4, you can say, tree with four vertices. So what is the answer for this? What should I write here?
Sir, k into k to k minus 1 to the power 3.
Yes, so k into k minus 1 raised to the power n minus 1. N is 4 here. So it's a 3 minus. You also know about this thing. Right? You know that in kn, what is the chromatic polynomial for kn? Yeah, so what do you want to write? Chromatic polynomial for kn. So it's a k3 using k colors. So what should I write here?
K into k minus 1, k minus 2.
Yes, only three term you'll write, k into k minus 1, k minus 2. So you know that in kn, it was k, k minus 1, k minus 2 till k minus n plus 1. So just n terms here, k3, you have just write three terms, there are three vertices only. Okay, let's simplify this. So this is easier, right? You don't have to think much about the partitions and all, just you now simplify. So you can take common k into k minus 1, so you are left with k minus 1 square, and here you are left with k minus 2, and just simplify it. So k into k minus 1, it's a k square minus 2k plus 1 minus k plus 2. So let's see what comes. K into k minus 1, and now k square and minus 2 minus 3 minus 3k plus 3. So don't you see the same result? So it's the same result, means it's the same as we know earlier. Okay, so it was k into k minus 1, k square minus 3k plus k. So any way you use, you will get the same result. So this is a chromatic polynomial for C4 using this chromatic recurrence formula. Okay, so you look and see if you have doubt. Now you know just P4 is a tree, so I used here P4 is a simple tree with four vertex. Okay, I will come to the proof. Before that, you try one more. So everyone, you have pen and paper, so you please try for this question. And so one more example I will write, right? Example. So graph G I will give you. This is a graph G. Okay, this is your graph G. And using the identity chromatic recurrence, you just find the chromatic polynomial for this graph. And let me give you, this is the edge E. Okay, now you try. So find the chromatic polynomial for this graph G, okay, in terms of K. You try it and tell me the answer. If you are not able to do, still you tell me, then I will solve it.
सर के इंटू के माइनस वन इंटू के स्क्वायर माइनस फोर के प्लस फोर.
ओके, सो लेट मी राइट द आंसर. सो यू आर टेलिंग द फाइनल आंसर के इंटू के माइनस वन
के माइनस वन के स्क्वायर माइनस फोर के प्लस फोर.
ओके, सो लेट मी चेक इट. सो लेट स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग. ओके, सो फर्स्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू फॉर्मूला यू नो chromatic polynomial for g minus e comma k minus क्रोमैटिक पॉलीमर फॉर जी डॉट ई कॉमा के. So anyone else would like to tell the answer if you have tried? I think he told the correct answer. So just let's check. So actually it is G. So you need to find G minus E. So if you find G minus E, G minus U, just remove that H. So remove that H, you will get okay C4. So this is nothing but C4. Okay, and g dot e means you will at both the endpoints, like say uv, so at both the endpoints you will take just one. Okay, so this and this will be as it is
one.
Okay, so thus this uv take w. Okay, in place of uv you take w, remove that. So here suppose I say it's a b, suppose, so it's a and b, so there is an edge from a to u, so a to w will take. Now v to u, so same thing, like VU are actually same vertex, and B to this. So is this going to be P3? Okay. So what do you do just?
Yes, sir.
You just in place of UV, you take one vertex, remove that edge, and then you join. So AU, AB, yeah. So multiple edges, you ignore multiple edges, just take one. So this G dot E is nothing but P4. Oh, sorry, P3 now. It's a P3.
Yes, sir, P3.
So G dot E is nothing but P3. So now chi of G minus E, that is C4 comma K minus chi of P3 comma K. Okay. And you already have the result for this. Eh? You don't have to much think about this. You already have the result. So result was K into K minus 1 K square minus 3 K plus 3. Was it? And minus for the P3. Actually, P3 is a tree with three vertices. P3 is a tree with three vertices. K into K minus 1 raised to power n minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. Okay. So P3 is a tree with
three vertices.
So now just you simplify. So you take common K into K minus 1. So you will be left with K square minus 3K plus 3 minus K minus 1. Okay, so you just simplify more. K square minus 3k plus 3 minus k plus 1, and you get k into k minus 1, then k square minus 4k plus 1. Yes, that is the answer. Okay, so you can do this and everyone will be able to find the answer actually. Okay, so we solved two examples based on this formula. Now remains the proof. I think our time is very less with us. So we'll prove in next class. So try one more question. Okay, so try one more question, then we'll finish today. And proof I will solve in next, I'll give you next class. So one more example you do. So the graph for you is this one. Okay, you can name it like A, B, C, D. Okay. And as E, you consider this one. So as E, you consider this one. Now tell me chromatic polynomial for graph G. Okay, in terms of K. So try it, everyone, and please tell me. I know you all can do simply.
सर के इंटू के माइनस वन का स्क्वायर इंटू के माइनस टू।
ओके So I think it's correct. So let me do. So just this is graph C, and so according to formula, you know, graph of G minus E comma K minus chromatic polynomial of G dot E comma K. So first you need to know what is this G minus E. So if you remove that E, and you just have to remove E. Okay, A, B, C, D. So in G minus E, you just have to remove that E. So this one, this one, this one. So what is the name of this graph? This is G minus E, which is actually P4, right? Again, you can say tree with four vertices. And G dot E, if you find. So for the G dot E, A, B, okay, C and D. But AC, you have to take as a single vertex, okay? So AC as same. So you can AC, you can replace with a new name. Okay. So any you can take, like W, let's say. So AC, since you are doing contraction, so AC is the same vertex. So B to C or B to A, both will be same. So AC is a one vertex and you remove that edge between them. So B to C or B to A is the same vertex, a same edge. And then C to A. So you can see this is G dot E, and which is nothing but P3, right? So now we have chromatic polynomial for G minus E was P4 comma K minus chromatic of P3 comma K. And you know P4, P4 is a tree with four vertex. So chromatic polynomial is K into K minus 1 raised to power 3. And P3 is a tree with three vertex, so K into K minus 1 square. Now you can take common K into K minus 1 square. Okay. So K minus 1 minus 1. And that's finally we get K into K minus 1 square into K minus 2. Is it the answer? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Am I doing right? I mean, was it correct now? Yeah, so
yes sir, yes sir.
Okay, so this is fine. So today actually we tried this recursive formula to find the chromatic polynomial. Okay, and we have now two ways. So the first way, using that formula, actually is a difficult task to do into partitions. So we use this chromatic recurrence method. So in next class I will prove this formula, and then we'll solve more problem based on this. Okay, so next class I would like to give the proof of this chromatic recurrence. Okay, and then we'll go for problems also, more problems on this. Okay, yeah, so I think that's all for today. Anyone had any doubt you would like to ask me?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, otherwise thank you. Yeah, thank you everyone. So see you in next class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.